unfortunately, today I'm giving you my reputation speech. According to Michael Hart, we observe that no intelligent beings from outer space are now present on Earth. It is suggested that this fact can be best explained by the hypothesis that there are no other advanced civilizations in our galaxy. Reasons given for rejecting all the alternative explanations on absence of extraterrestrials on Earth. There are many people who study the life outside of Earth, more specifically, Cynoologists. They are scientists who study extraterrestrial life. They use modern technology to track any type of extraterrestrial activity around the galaxy. There would be no way extraterrestrial life would be able to travel to Earth or throughout the galaxy because space travel is infeasible. Traveling to different planets or around the galaxy would just simply take too long. This would be physical evidence as to why aliens don't exist. Space travel is unreasonably dangerous. Extraterrestrials would have to face the effects of cosmic rays, unpredictable collisions with meteoroids, and lastly, the biological effects of prolonged weightlessness. My second point is that humans have been trying to communicate with aliens for decades. There are two aspects of our communication with aliens, how we send it and what we say. There have been vigorous discussion about both facets of intergalactic communication. Scientists currently broadcasting themselves across the universe through radio signals just to get some type of reply back. It's the year 2019 and we still have no physical evidence that extraterrestrial life exists around the galaxy. We as humans have been able to communicate for the last 60 to 70 years and have revolutionized the art of communication. Scientists often rely on radio science in the search of extraterrestrial life, but technology today is so advanced that it can easily prove these claims. More importantly, if we can't physically find them, then there must be a way to communicate, and that is still yet to be proven. According to NASA.gov, but unless we get lucky, the search for signs of life could take decades. Discovering another blue-white marble hidden in the star field is like sand grain on the beach. It will probably require an even larger imaging telescope. Designs are already underway for that next generation planet finder to be set alone in the 2030s and 2040s. For intelligent extraterrestrials to exist just like humans, they probably need water and food or some type of source to support life, and this hasn't been discovered. Ice sheets have been discovered on the south pole of Mars, but it is so limited that it would only be able to fuel small self-organisms. A planet just like Earth would have to exist to provide the basic needs of what extraterrestrials need. Many believe that extraterrestrials are made out to be just like humans, meaning they would need the same resources to live. There are hundreds and billions of planets that can provide the basic needs of an extraterrestrial, but it almost seems impossible that Earth 2.0 exists. There are also many gas properties in outer space that would make it difficult for other planets to be habitable. Many scientists are discovering new planets that are habitable, but the most important thing about discovering these new planets are how close it is to its stars. Is there water and oxygen? And would other humans or any other forms of extraterrestrial life be able to exist on it? In conclusion, extraterrestrial life does not exist until proven. There's just simply not enough evidence to prove the statement. It would take years and years of technology advancement, a lot of math that's just way too much to solve, space travel and technology that's beyond our years to eventually travel and explore to other planets. Scientologists, astronomers, and astrophysicists have a long way to prove that extraterrestrials exist and it would not happen in our lifetime. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.